I've been looking for a Lu rod to match my exact specifications, and finally I have got it. Right, and now about the rod itself. That's a Kuying Battle Song BSS652ML. I needed this exact rod for my kayak fishing. I needed a rod which is in length close to 2 meters, but just not over 2 meters, because when I am kayak fishing, I like to keep my rod in between my legs when I am like maneuvering, and then if the rod will be just under 2 meters, the tip won't go over the side of the boat and I won't risk breaking it like when crashing into other boats possibly. Then I needed a rod which would have a casting up to 20 grams, I would say, and this one has from 5 to 18. I worked out that 20 grams maximum by simply adding 10 centimeter lure, like soft lure, because I bought this rod for my bigger fish fishing, so 10 centimeter silicone lure, it's about 5 grams, and then in the situations when where I'm fishing, mostly it's like lead weight is about from 3 to 10 grams, so 5 plus 10, that's about 15 grams. So, and this kind of casting rating maximum, 18 grams, is ideal really. And also I needed a short handle. Obviously the shorter the handle when you are on the boat, the better really. So yeah, probably I was one of the first people to order this rod, because this rod is quite new actually to Kuying's line of rods. I have to say that I purchased this rod using cash out of my own pocket, so it's not paid review. Also, I have to mention that I haven't tried this rod on the water, but I have plenty of other rods, so I believe I have plenty of valid points to tell about this rod. Even though this rod has quite a high specifications, it's not too expensive, so the prices as of 2020 May are as follows. It will be 65 Great British pounds, about 70 euros, and 85 United States dollars. The rod came in a hard plastic tube, obviously, as always. Then the rod came in a, like, not actually as luxury sleeve as usually from Kuying, even though it has like 3 layers, but the middle layer is not, like, it's not padded, so I don't know why they made it a little bit cheaper. Probably because the rod is quite a high specification, even though the prices are not as high. Now about the rod itself. Let's start with the butt section. As you can see, the handle is pretty short, and the distance from the end to the reel seat is about 25 centimeters. Then I have to say that the blank itself has like quite pleasant, actually, kind of dark teal or dark blue color, like butt section and tip section as well. I hope you can see it on the camera. Then the handle, as you can see, has 2 parts which are made out of cork, and the handle has some like green and brown metal elements as well, which do match with everything else quite nicely actually. Since the reel seat is Fuji, obviously, and even though it's not like my favorite type of handle, but still, when I'm holding the rod, still I can put my finger onto the blank. Then the guides are obviously Fuji. As far as I know, those are the Fuji Fazline new type of guides, or the inserts. And the first guide on the rod from the reel is quite decent size actually, so it means that you will be able to use bigger reels. Then the tip section, that's a tubular tip, I have to say straight away, and it has 6 rings or guides on the tip section. And the action of the rod is fast. I won't say that it's crazy fast or something like that, but it's really, really fast action. Also, I have to mention that this rod is quite light. It weighs just over 100 grams. So for that kind of specification, medium light rod, that's very, very good actually, and for the price as well. The casting rating from 5 to 18 grams is very accurate in my opinion. I play it with different lures and it kinda bends just the right amount when you're loading it like with 15 grams I tried. So yeah, in my opinion the casting rating is accurate, even so I haven't tried it on the water. And I believe that this rod has a little bit like of a reserve, if you like. I don't think that you will be able like to break it or something if you will use it with a little bit heavier weight, like 20 grams. I think it will be able to cope with that kind of weight, just no problem. I have tried to match this rod with a few different reels, and I discovered that you need a reel which weighs just over 200 grams, like 210 or so. 220 matches with this rod very well as well. So I put a Daiwa Fuego LT 2500 and will show you the balance. It's more or less perfect, as you can see. Sits really, really beautiful in my hand. Very, very fast action as well, as I mentioned. But it will be it from me for today. I hope you will find this content useful. Also, if you will decide to purchase this rod or this reel yourself or that set yourself, please consider using those links below. Thanks for watching and see you in the next one.